Kilometres of concrete, barbed wire and armed guards. The Berlin Wall was an icon of cruelty that 30 years ago was chipped away by hand and hammer. And with its fall, a new future was unlocked. That future bright and on display tonight.
A city celebrating freedom long after emerging from its communist past. The Brandenburg Gate awash with colour and 30,000 messages of love and hope.
Was for me the greatest moment in my life.
This was the moment that marked the end of the Cold War. November 1989, euphoric scenes as the great divide separating the communist East from the capitalist West was finally torn down. East Berliners clambering over and hammering through the 160-kilometre-long concrete barrier to be reunited with loved ones for the first time in 28 years. Peter Scollin from Adelaide was at Checkpoint Charlie when news broke the East German government was reopening the border.
The border guards didn't really know what was going on. The people going across didn't really know whether they could come back or how they get back or whatever, but there was just this feeling of we're just doing it.
An astonishing moment in history which was triggered by a mistake after an East German official botched a press conference prematurely telling journalists citizens were free to move across the border immediately without delay. The wall was built almost overnight in 1961 to stop an exodus of people fleeing communist East Germany to the more prosperous West. Fortified with armed guards, it created a physical and ideological barrier. Thousands of people attempted to escape. More than 100 died trying. Today, German Chancellor Angela Merkel remembered those victims at Bernauer Strasse, the street separating East from West. Despite repeated efforts by US presidents John F. Kennedy in 1963,
all free men, wherever they may live, are citizens of Berlin.
And Ronald Reagan in 1987,
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
It was people power that prevailed, a wave of peaceful revolution sweeping communist states that finally forced the East German government to free its oppressed people. A few weeks later, on New Year's Eve, actor David Hasselhoff put the feelings of a nation into words.
I've been looking for freedom.
While Germany today is united, simmering beneath these celebrations tonight is still a lingering divide. 30 years later, the East is still playing catch-up with lower wages, weaker economies and a population that continues to decline.
What was once an ugly scar of the Iron Curtain has since transformed into the world's largest open-air gallery, a canvas for more than 100 artists celebrating freedom three decades on. In Berlin, Sophie Walsh, 9 News.